Well, I'm not sure if you can see me, but just thought I'd give a go and the old air bomb today, trialing it out. As you can see, I got a lot of weed on it. What I'm doing is firing the bait just where the weed ends, just clearing the weed, and then obviously this is landing in there and pulling that weed out as well. So fingers crossed, grab one on the bank today. Making a nice, nice blanket of bed bait there. Not too far spread out, which is quite nice. So the rod's on there. See what happens. One more in the middle again now, and it's a nice blanket of bait there. I was just about to recast that then, but I'm just to the little bit to the right where I just baited up. I was going to recast it into that better bait that I've just done, but as you can see, I just had a bit of a bleep then, bit of a line there, I think. So I'll just hang on for five, see what happens. So I'm on the yellow popper. This is what caught me that one last Friday, I think it was. Still nice. Well, not exactly that same popper, but on the old probate TT, so you've got that nice sweet flavour. And that was tried pinks. Yellow seemed to be the one then. Unfortunately, I had to go, so couldn't really test any more then. I was going too far to the right. Obviously, then that would mean I'd have to go further right. Give my right hand rod. Recast again. I'm not putting any PVA bags or anything on this. Single bait, pop up, going to the amount of bait that I just put out. Not a lot, but hopefully it gets some grubbing. A little bit further back just to get beyond that wee bit. If I'm lucky enough to catch one and it runs for the weed, well, that's what I'm going to play. See how it goes from there. Don't mind playing them in the weed, it's quite fun. Obviously, we're taking the weed, but back up straight into the sorry, just felt that really go straight into that silt then, so fishing this one with a leg clipper, got quite a bit of a boom on it to hopefully keep it out of that silt and the pop up to obviously then keep it popped up. It's a really buoyant one, so it should float down quite slowly. So yeah, just sinking the line and go from there. Normally I would use back legs, but I'm not at the moment. As you can see, you dip your rod in, wind the hand a little bit, and that line will sink quicker. Just be careful not to pull your lead. And then all I do then is bail armor, put the rod on, 30 seconds on the alarm so it doesn't annoy the hell out of myself or anyone else, and then slowly wind in. Have it the tension you want it. Don't forget, obviously, your swing arm. See, that's really bow tight, which is why I don't like the moment. So I put a little bit more off, because obviously the indicator will go on. Pull that line a little bit tight as well. Then I got the adjuster then, just to make it not so heavy. And the clip to give me that more aggressive angle. An indication. That's it, I'm happy with that. Next one now. I'll go over to my spot now where I've been casting from. That one won two bags, it's quite close. But I'm going to go over to the spot that I've marked up there with a stone. Cast over to the tree. Roughly got a feeling for it now, but it was wrapped up at the beginning to the length. And this one is a heli style on the naked. These fox hooks are really sharp, but yeah, she's on a naked line. Got a buffer there and a buffer up there. So when it plugs into the silt, that should slowly, that will go up the line. Hopefully come sink back down, so got a foot of silt maybe. Just measure it from there to there. Might want to go up a little bit. So yeah, that should do me. Again, popper. Yellow TT from Probate. See how it goes. Wind them in. Okay. Basically aiming for the tree and the bay. Well, you've got the bay and then you've got the tree and then you've got another bay. I'm just aiming for that tree. As long as I'm within 6 foot, of the bait, then I'm happy with that. Normally I'd go nice and tight to the island, but today it's giving me a go about a rod, maybe a rod and a half off. Should be on the same spot. Normally you'd have it wrapped up, clipped up and hitting it in, but I'm literally 3 hours today, so I'm just out on a bit of fun. Which is what I do every time, but this time not so critical. That's the one. Set him up, not bowstring tight again, just nice little bit of slack line. Felt the lead, so just giving a little bit of more line off. Just helping it sink. I'm not sure if you can see that, but just starting to move the rod now in the middle. There we go, line's under. So bail arm off. Pull my rod back. 30 seconds on the under arm again. Bail arm back on. So this is as closed basically. I'll just give it some more line. There we go. I'm happy with that now. That's a good thing. Nice slack line. Not too slack on the side. So just having a little wander and found a few over by the bank by here. which you might not be able to see because of the glare. You just see one in that bay there. So if I do this, it should give you a nice view there. Just see him just swimming across in that bay again. You can see the difference what the glasses do. There he is, look. There's a difference there. So, not sure if you can see that, but there's two on the clear patch to the left, and there's three just to the right. So again, I shall put the old glasses on. You might be able to just see them there. Just literally swimming about. And there's the other two now, just going into the weed. So they're not venturing that far out from the banks today. Obviously still a bit cold. Yeah, I might just get one rod and have a little sneaky chuck by there, see what happens.